up to yesterday, we had done 199 online classes. So today is number 200. So I think we all deserve a round of applause for keeping going that length of time. So well done, everyone, and thank you very much. I did post it on my Facebook and on my Instagram, just so people didn't think we've been sitting around for a whole year. So what we'll do today is we're going to start with our wake up. So underneath the collarbones, tapping, waking up that kidney meridian, in through the nose and out through the mouth. If you don't feel like tapping, then of course just massage, okay? And up and down the sternum. Lovely long out breath. Underneath the arms, any way you wish. And underneath the eyes. Get all the energies moving, talking to one another. And shake that off the hands. Right, same hand as the knee, let's go. Increasing the energies to move across the body, so smooth off the hands, off we go here. We're getting the energy crossing over. Good to do every morning. Hands in front of the pubic bone. Here we're going to zip that up. You can also bring an affirmation or a positive statement into your day. So on your in-breath, draw that up. And then put that affirmation in your field, like your outer body. And the hook up, middle finger, belly button, and the third eye. Push in, hook it up, and hold for three breaths. That should get all your energies moving around your body and in the right direction. So let's just shake that up. All right, so bring the feet. Sorry about that. Moves around when I do that. Bring your feet to hip width apart. Hands to the prayer position. We're going to just connect with that energy by doing our heaven and earth. Okay, so soft through the knees. On an in-breath, you're going to take one palm up, one palm down. So connecting up. And then on your out-breath, you're just going to let the palms pass each other, feeling the energy in them, and then going in the other direction for your in-breath. So be careful as you warm up through the side body. Just take your time, make a nice long breath out of it. And you can start sort of side bending deeper when it feels right. Just feel as though you're connecting to that energy. Do one more out. Stretching a bit deeper. Cross the hands at the heart, close the eyes, just check in with the wake up and that heaven and earth. Your mind and your body fully present on your mat. Super. So opening the eyes, keeping the feet here. We're going to come in for a deeper side stretch. So on your in-breath, take the arms up. Take your right hand and hold your left wrist. And then you're going to pull away. So you're going to pull upwards towards the ceiling. And then you're going to pull over. You're not pushing the hips out, you're just lifting sort of from this whole area, and feel the soles of your feet connect with the earth, so you feel really grounded. And then breathe into that stretch, chest nice and open. When we come up, push through the feet, tuck the belly. And then we're going to stay here if you can and just switch the switch the wrists, okay? So draw that arm up to the ceiling, then take it over. So really feel that breath and that stretch. Still be able to feel grounded through the feet. Then push into the three, tuck the belly as you come back up. And release all the way down. Bring the hands back to the prayer position. We'll open up through the shoulders. We'll do our flow. So on your in-breath, open the chest, take the arms up like you're going to sort of sing. On the out-breath, bring the hands in front, interlace the fingers. Turn the palms to me and push away through the back of the shoulders, in-breath coming up. Arching through your spine if that feels safe. And then on the out-breath, hands behind the head, tuck the elbows in. Next in-breath, elbows and nose upwards. And on your out-breath, release. So bring the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers, roll the shoulders back, knuckles down. And then in-breath, take the arms behind, open the chest, shoulder blades together. And then on your out-breath, keep the hands here, bring the palms together, and then run the thumbs and then the fingers up your spine into reverse prayer. On your next in-breath, take the elbows behind and lift the chest. Or you can cross over. And on your out-breath, release. Bring your arms above the head. And finish at the prayer position. So we'll just do one more. Although you're moving the arms, think shoulders, okay? So opening up on your in-breath. And closing down on your out-breath. Interlace those fingers, turn the palms. In-breath, stretching up, arching into that spine, and the out-breath, hands behind the head, elbows tuck in into the nose, and the in-breath, nose and elbows ceiling, and the out-breath, release, hands behind, interlace those fingers, roll the shoulders back, knuckles down, in-breath, lift the chest, shoulder blades together, on the in-breath, out-breath, release. Hands in the prayer position, run the fingers up the spine. And then on your in-breath, elbows back. Out-breath to gently release. And on the in-breath, stretching up. And the out-breath, back to center. Okay, we need to warm up through the legs, so we're going to do our hip mobilizer. So grab your block. So this doubles up as a balance as well. So take your right foot onto that block. Hands under the hips or anywhere that you feel is best to stabilize. And then the other foot, the sole of the foot is level with the floor. I'm going to move through this hip. Okay. So we're going to do five. So we're going to take, drop it into the floor that doesn't quite touch. And then we're going to tuck it up into our ribs. Drop it down and then tuck it up. So both legs are straight and the shoulders stay parallel as you move through the hips. Your range of movement might be different to mine. Whoop. Might be less than mine. And this is not one to rush. And then switch legs. So good for mobilizing the pelvis, okay? So dropping down, lifting up. Just squeeze into those ribs. Well done. Okay, pop that block to the side. We're going to come to the front of our mats. Feet are going to be hip width apart. And today when we come back, we're going to have the hands at the heart instead of in the prayer position. Okay? So feet hip width apart. From here, we're going to come straight down into our chair. So tuck in the belly, sitting back. Just a little way because we're warming, still warming up through the legs. Chest lifts, spine is nice and long. So let's move into our balance. So the weight tips forward onto the toes and then we lengthen out on an in-breath. Feel as though you're pushing the toes into the floor. And on your out-breath, you're going to come back down straight into that chair. So we're working through these legs. And again, come on your toes early, in-breath. Strengthening through the legs helps us to stand in our truth, stand in our courage, which is that spring element of wood. As they say, solid as an oak. Keep going. Maybe you can come deeper into your chair now that whole area is warming up. This time stay down in your chair once you're back there. We're going to swan dive into a forward bend, so on an out breath. If you want to keep your knees bent for now, then do. Just drop your head and feel a softness through the face. Releasing any tension in the face, keep the hands there for now. Release the hands behind the legs, behind the knees for a half forward bend, so lift the chest, shoulder blades down to the waist, keep looking towards the floor. Now maybe the legs are straight. Next out breath, place the hands on the floor, right leg into a plank, and hold and feel the strength in that. From here we're going to walk into a little squat, so just walk the feet forward, hip width apart, and from here we're going to try and keep the hips nice and low as we take the leg back and bring it forward. Okay, so feel the hands into the floor, lift up a little bit, take the right leg back and stay nice and low and push the heel backwards, so you're opening through that hip. All right, and then tuck it back in, and we'll do four of those. So stay nice and low, take it back. Feel the muscles wrap around the bones of that leg. Not too fast, feel into it once you get there. If you feel a little bit cramped, you can always bring your hands onto a block. Okay, other leg. Feel into it, feel the strength through these legs. Four on this side as well. Okay, let me just turn around. From here we're in our squat, we're going to do expelling the venom, which is all about releasing the anger. So come onto your feet, but you're still low to the ground. Imagine you're on standing on some grass and you're going to pick up tufts of grass like they're your the anger that gets stuck and stored in our body. The sound to release is a shh. Okay, so on your in-breath, bring the arms above the head. Throw it all away and come down to the sound. Shh. Again, you can just say you're picking up the anger in your body. It doesn't need to be any more specific than that, unless you can recall it. On your in-breath, bring the arms up. Throw it away, let it go. Shh. And we'll do one more. In breath coming up. And let it go. Shh. Let's just lying here for a moment so we can feel into that. And then the hands on the floor, left leg leads in to our plank. And a downward facing dog, so set your dog up, feet hip width apart, fingers are nice and wide, gripping onto that mat, shoulders are wide, tailbone up. If you want to move the feet, the legs around, then please do. Next in breath, take the right leg behind, out breath, bring that forward, back heel to the floor, no arms come up, warrior legs. Feel strong through those legs. We're going to take the right hand under the arm, left hand on your above your elbow. Triple warmer spleen hold for our safety and our security. So we're going to sort of hold onto the ribs, if you like, as we in-breath and just lean to this back leg. So the weight's going to be on this back leg, okay? Again, feel the muscles wrap around the bones, nice and strong. Like you're hugging yourself in this position. Enjoy a breath. In the next out breath, bring the hands to the floor. Forward bend split. Just going to move out the telly. Bring your leg back. You can put your toe or your heel, I don't mind, whichever you feel gives you more release. We're just going to hold this today, we're not going to move. So look behind you. Now the left foot comes next to the right, hip width apart. Hands into the heart and then come back up into our chair. So tuck the belly as you lift up, lift the chest. Five more of our movements, so onto the toes and lift up. Coming back down on our out breath. Off we go. I'll do one more. Again, out breath, swan dive into your forward bend. Keep the hands where they are. Half forward bend, hands behind the knees, lift the chest. Stand, hold. Hands to the floor, you can jump or step back into your downward facing dog. Next in breath, take the left leg behind and then bring that between the hands, back heel to the floor, rise up, no arms, feel into those feet. So this time it's the left hand under the right arm and the right hand onto your spleen, hug those ribs. On an in breath, leaning back into that back leg, engage that back leg. Really engage. Soft shoulders, soft face. Next out breath, forward bend split. Hands to the floor or use your blocks. And lift the leg up. Look behind. Again, into your chair with that right foot hip width apart. Hands to the heart, gently bring yourself up, tucking the belly. And let's go for four more. movement through those legs. Working with your breath. So remaining in your chair when you finish them all. One more swan dive down on an out breath. Hands to the floor, step jump, or walk back into your downward facing dog. Super. See what those legs are feeling like? So keep the toes tucked, we're going to come onto the knees. Bring the elbows onto the floor, underneath your shoulders, bottom onto the heels. Bring the pads of the hands on just under the eyes, so on the bones of the eyes, under the eyes. Thumbs on the outside of the eyes and the fingers wrapping around the front of the head. And drop the face into the hands. Engaging your ujjayi breath, that restricted breath in your throat, or a nice just long, slow breath. So we're holding some neuroreflex points on the head here. Is very calming to the whole body. Okay, so gently bring yourself up. That is one I could stay there all day with. So finding your block, we're going to sit on it, but we're going to straddle it. If that feels uncomfortable for your knees, then add another block underneath so you're a little bit higher up, or you can come to sitting. So once you're in this position, you're going to take your fingers and you're going to massage in between the ribs either side of your sternum. So you're just going to move up and down. This is the neurolymphatic point or the gallbladder. And the gallbladder and the liver, we support during the spring, that time of detoxification. Right, so if there's a sore spot, then just stay with it and just massage a little bit more. And then to the liver, neurolymphatic, and that's underneath the breast or the chest, so just all along that line. If it feels too tender, then come down, further down into the ribs, doesn't matter. And again, if you find a little bit of a sore spot, then stay with that. Just freeing up all the lymphs. Helping us feel spring-like. All right, just shake off the fingers. Bring the hands just above on the shoulders, elbows out to the side, sort of parallel with the floor. We're going to bring a twist into the spine. So take this nice and slow, and you're going to twist from the waist. So on your in-breath, you're going to turn in one direction, and on the out-breath, you're going to turn in the other. Now, as you turn, the elbow that's coming behind, I want you to squeeze the shoulder blade of that side in towards the spine. So it's not just a twist. It's a bit of squeeze of those back muscles. So we don't want to rush this, but we want to feel into it as we take that elbow around. Still keeping the shoulders nice and soft. Right, let's finish on this next round. And then from here, on your in-breath, take the arms out to the side for a big stretch. We're going to come into eagle arms. So, elbow into elbow. Doesn't matter which side. You're going to wrap round or backs of the hands, or indeed here, depending on the how the shoulders are feeling. You can close your eyes. I just want you to focus on the stretch. And take your in-breath to expand into that stretch. And the out breath to soften that whole space. If you want to deepen into the stretch, push the elbows forward and take the fingers up. And use the breath again to expand into it. Slowly come out on an in-breath, take the arms out to the side, big stretch through the chest. And the out-breath, other elbow into the elbow. And come in. Settle in and feel into the stretch. Soft through the shoulders, so the neck still remains long, the spine is nice and long. And the breath is expanding into your back. And if you want to go deeper, elbows forward, fingers up. Breath, release, take the arms out. Lovely. And on your out breath, interlace the fingers behind, roll the shoulders back, knuckles down, lift the chest on an in breath. We're going to come over for a stretch through the shoulders, so arms over the head. Maybe the forehead meets the floor, who knows? If the shoulders feel tight, then use a strap. Release the arms and gently bring the chest back up. Oh, and release. All right, coming off the block then. Place at the top of your mat. We'll probably need it when we lie down. So on all fours and then back to a downward facing. Okay. On your next in-breath, take the right leg behind, bring that foot forward, back knee is going to come to the floor, keep the left hand where it is, tuck the chin, right arm up, opening that chest, shoulder blade tucks to the spine, flick each finger once, and then all of them together twice, waking up those meridians, and let's circle to the back of the mat first, to the floor, to the front and then above our head. We'll do that three times. Shoulders should be lovely and mobile now. From here, we're going to take the right forearm to the right thigh. And then we're going to turn in the opposite direction, but keep that back knee on the floor. We're going to take the left arm behind us and bring it all the way up on an in-breath and then bring it over our head. left hand to the floor and bring the back knee up, back heel to the floor. Let's do the same again. So in a circle, take that left arm around. And now we get a little bit deeper with it. Push into the outside of that left foot. And then into the fingers. Right, this left arm, we're going to circle back and then end up in a downward facing dog. Next in breath, take the left leg behind. And the out breath, foot between the hands, back knee to the floor. Tuck the chin, left arm coming up into that reverse twist. Drop the shoulder blade to the spine. Flick each finger once. And then all of them together. And then three of those big circles with the arm for the shoulder. And hold that side of that torso, having a stretch out. Three times. Excuse my back here, so left forearm to the left thigh, open up, swing the arm behind you, and then bring it over the head. Bring that right hand to the floor, lift that back knee, come onto the foot, scoop that arm again, and come all the way around. Circle that arm again and come back into a downward facing dog. Let's step, walk or jump to the front of your mat, feet together this time. And into a full forward bend, which should be ready for that if you want to. Take your hands to the backs of your legs, you can, or keep them on the floor. Bend the knees, all the way up. Arms out to the side, lift the chest. And we'll finish with the hands at the heart, one on top of the other. So, to our balance, find your belt. Building up to a bind with this balance, but for now we'll stick with our strap to give us a hand. So small loop, right foot, just attach it around the pad of the foot, and you're going to hold the strap in the same hand as the bind. Take the other hand onto the hip, just helps you to anchor in. The standing leg, press the toes into the floor and lift the top of the foot up. Tuck the belly tailbone down and let's just lift that leg up. Keep the elbow tucking in, long spine. Grab a wall if you want one. Finding your gentle focus somewhere. Ready for when we go in a bit deeper. Stay working on this leg. Take the knee out and we're going to bring the hand closer to that foot. Okay, come back to your position. This time the leg's going to go out straight in front. You can let the strap run through that hand. Okay, so long spine. Keep the elbow tucked. See how high you can get that leg without leaning backwards. So mine is already freeing up a bit for the last couple of weeks doing this. It's always a process. And always keep that breath moving. When you want to stop and just hold on, just take the leg out to the side. Always keep that other hip facing forward. So if that means coming back with a leg, it doesn't matter. Keep your focus, that will really help. Try not to lean too far over to the opposite side. Fabulous. In breath, the comeback. Just control it all the way. Yes, and out breath, the comeback. Oh, well done. Just have a wiggle through that other ankle and then we'll go into that side. So let's bring the belt onto that foot. Exactly the same thing. Engage this leg, feel the foot into the floor. And from here, we're just going to lift the foot. So we just get the balance, we get the focus. Everything is just sort of lining itself up for when we go deeper. Engage the buttock, everything. Just make sure you're standing solid, like that tree we spoke about earlier. Okay, so coming out, take that hand closer to that foot. Reset yourself, nice long spine, tuck the belly. Bring that leg out. Tuck that elbow in, soft shoulders. Yes, that's definitely getting better. I hope yours is too. When you feel ready, let's take that leg out to the side. And breathe. And breathe. All right, let's in breath return. Control and the out breath. Good job, good job. Take that belt off and have a move around through those ankles. Right. Back to the front of your mats then. Feet together this time, hands across the heart again. Roll the shoulders back, tailbone down, tuck the belly, lengthen the spine. Standing in your courage, standing in your power. So on your in-breath, take the arms out, look up, stretch up. Celtic weave into a forward bend. And a half forward bend, hands behind the knees. Jump or step back, whichever leg, into your plank and hold for a second. Knees, hips, chin all the way to the floor and an out breath. And an up dog on your next in breath. Tuck your toes, come straight up into a downward facing dog. Just sort of flow through it. Bend your knees, step or jump forward, feet together. Ending up in a half forward bend and a full forward bend. Bend the knees, lift the chest, arms out to the side, in breath all the way up. And the hands are going to cross at heart. In breath, lift the chest, and on an out breath into your chair. Hold it here for one in breath. And an out breath, swan dive down, forward bend, you can release the hands. In breath, half forward bend. Into your plank. And hold. Bend these hips, chin all the way to the floor. And your next in breath, into your up dog. This time you're going to come back just onto your knees. And walk the knees to the long edge of your mat and then swing those legs around. belt again. We're going to just practice into our boat. So just sort of halfway with the belt. Oh, feet together and bring them under the pads of the feet. Okay, so bring the heels in. You want the hands nice and close to the feet. And a nice long spine. Tuck the belly and just lean back so you bring the feet off the floor. Find your focus. And then from here, play with those legs so. You can come out sort of halfway. Keep the elbows tucking in, use the biceps. If that feels steady enough, then see if you can straighten the legs. And straightening the legs is a bit of a gradual process. They don't always want to go straight immediately. Keep the chest lifted so you can stay in this V shape. Super duper. If you roll out, come back in. Okay, gently come down. We're going to try and bind with the fingers and the toes. If that's not happening yet, then come back into this one again, okay? So, first two fingers between the big toe and the next one. Walk the heels in, lift the chest, tuck the belly. And then just come back to that balance again. So just get the heels off the floor. And then start to play with these legs. I normally take one up at a time. And then I just feel into the balance a little bit better. If you're here, that's magical because you're in a fantastic balance. Just have a play with the legs. Sometimes if you try and straighten them too quick, you'll just rock back. I always find this lovely stretch through my shoulders. Fabulous. Control your descent out as well, if you can. Onto the floor, we're going to come onto our back. So spleen hold, triple warmer, tuck the chin, engage all your bundles and slowly come down. So we've been working on the electrics in our body, so we're going to do that today. We're going to find our block. I mean, you can use some cushions or a bolster, whatever you've got. Bring that underneath your tailbone. So the idea is to bring the legs into the air. If you want to pop your legs up against the wall, then please do. So just gently bring the legs up. If you want to do, you know, like a passive butterfly, wherever you feel happy for your legs to be. They don't need to be stiff straight. Just find an ideal spot. Make sure you've got the block far enough towards the front of your mat and then it'll sort of kick the legs forward. So a bit easier. Right. Bring the hands to the base of your skull and where the spine meets. There's a big hollow there and I'd like you to start to massage into that whole space. Feeling if there's any tender spots. So this is now waking up your electrical system saying, we're now going to do a bit of work here, and then you start to massage out, still at the base of your skull, out towards the ears. You'll feel those big muscles there. If you just come outside of those a little bit closer towards the ears, you'll find another hollow, not as obvious either side. If you massage in there, bring your elbows to rest on the floor, and then stop massaging there and just bring the fingers so there's some pressure into that, those hollows. Close the eyes. Then tune in to any sensations you can feel as you make that connection. Every cell in the body has an electrical charge. I want those cells to be as charged up as possible. We need the cells to be cells to be healthy, to look after us, so that we can feel well. Maybe a pulse there. Feel the pulse, see if they synchronize. So if you feel this, it'd be a benefit. You can do anything from 5 to, you know, 10, 15, 20 minutes. Especially if you're feeling energetically drained, or you've been unwell. So for us though, we're going to massage into the hollows again, where we've just been holding. We need to just tell the body we're now going to leave. So you don't want to just take your hand straight off. And now we're going to smooth down the sides of the neck and off the shoulders 3 times. And then you're going to bend your knees. Find your 4th toe and just give it a little bit of a squeeze and a massage. So, beginning of the gallbladder meridian, this one. That's where we hold the back of the legs, because it comes up, you know, behind the knees. And then the big toes, so the liver point is sort of on the inside bed of the big nail, but just give it all a bit of a squeeze, because there's various meridians that come through the big toe. Again, if any time it feels a bit tender, then be brave and stay in that spot for a second. Just massage around. And bring those feet back down to the floor. Come off your block for a moment. And straighten out the legs. Last one into the hips. So we're going to drag this left, take the arms out to the side. We're going to drag this left heel in towards your bottom and take the foot and drag it out towards the left. And drop that left knee in towards the middle of the mat. Push it down as you feel a stretch through the left hip. Bring the knee back up. Drag the foot in and then straighten it out and relax, completely relax before we go again. Off we go then, drag the heel in, drop the knee in. The idea is that we don't use much of the muscles, it's like a real drag, like the leg is heavy. And then bring that knee back up. Drag the foot in and then straighten out. Let's go to the other leg then. You can do a lot more at home if you wish, especially if your hips are tight. Or even down into the thighs, sometimes you feel it. Bring the knee back up, drag that foot in, and then straighten the leg and relax. Once more, take it out to the side and push it in. And straighten the leg out, just resting. Then find the block again, walk the feet in. Coming for your full body stretch. So you use the block or not worry, you can also bring it a little bit higher if you want. I might do that today. Just be careful of your lower back though. And bring the arms above the head if that feels alright for your shoulders. So we've worked quite a bit into the hips, so that's quite a deep stretch out. Nice with the block, you can let that do the work. All right, bring the arms over the head and walk the feet back in. Remove the block and get yourself ready for relaxation, shavasana. Legs are out straight, space between the heels, arms are gently away from the body with the palms face up. And close the eyes. So taking a few deep breaths and allowing yourself to settle into your space. Let the out breath release any remaining tightness in the body, any remaining stress or tension. Feel the body releasing. Now bring your awareness to your spine. And move your body slightly backwards and forwards, just feeling the spine in your body. You can do our snake movement where the hips gently slide one way and the shoulders slide the other. And let your spine be like a tree moving gently in the breeze. And let the movements bring your awareness into your spine itself. And now start to slow down the movement until you can just be in your spine, but with your body still. Visualize your brain and the spinal column full of bright light. You can add a color to this if you wish. And see the whole area illuminated with your bright colored light. Within the bright light, feel the steadfastness, the way the spine holds us upright. supports so much of our body. In that standing upright, that support of the spine, comes the courage. So stay here, bathing your spine in your light. Beauty and the importance of our spine. The spinal column that houses all the nerves. The nerves that communicate with the rest of our body. Resting in the splendor of your spine. Also the healing experience of the focus on the spine. If there's some specific healing, then request that now. Say what you would like your spine to be. To your spine. Allow the light to fade and return to your breath. Let us lengthen into the breath as we reawaken. Bring a movement into the hands and the feet. To the rest of the body. So bending your knees, rolling onto your right side, hands under the head for a pillow. Aware of the practice today and the effect on the body and the mind. Let's push up to seated, but crossing the palms at the heart again. Strength and courage. Namaste.